is going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I'm Freddy Fogel, Flaming Hot Entertainment, MultiPlatGameTrap.com, the people's voice and your favorite average gamer. Gonna be bringing you a review of the Elgato Game Capture HD, which I hold the box in my hand. And I just wanted to bring the box in size comparison to the old HD PVR by Huphog. This box does not represent the size of the new HD PVR 2 gaming edition. So it is probably a third smaller than this. So it's probably about almost two and a half sizes the size of this box. But just to show you the size of it, give you some type of a visual cue. And as soon as you get it, you're going to realize, okay, nice packaging. And you open it up, it has all the things in there. It tells you how to get started, where to go to get the software for it. You download it free from their websites. And it does support both Mac and PC. I don't know if it supports Linux, but I do know it supports Mac and PC. The software is very mature. It is very well put together, very nice, simple, looks visually appealing. Looks visually appealing, works great, doesn't really tax your PC or Mac as much as something, say, like Fraps or anything, if you wanted to use it to, like, record gaming PC. I mean, game on your PC or Mac. Now, here goes my old Huphog. This is the 1212 model HD PVR. This was the industry standard for a long time. And I'm going to say that the new industry standard right now is set by the Elgato. For the fact that it's small, it can fit in your pocket, it doesn't need a power brick, it's powered by mini USB, it has a HDMI in, HDMI out, and then a component. It has a proprietary chip plug, but it does have component, and then the red, green, and blue, and then analog sound. So you can do both. If you see back there, I prefer the analog sound because I go through my mixer, and then I put in my gaming, my live commentary that way. It comes with pretty good cables, long enough USB cable to go to your computer, then a short HDMI cable, and it just provides one. So that's one thing on the Huphog HD PVR 2, it came with two that were longer than this, and they were actually gold-plated HDMI cables, and this isn't. And everything on the Huphog was gold-plated, this isn't. But doesn't take away from the fact that the software on here gives you a max of 30 megabytes per second bitrate. You can go in, change like your saturation, the contrast, brightness, and that actually shows up on the image that you're seeing on the TV. There's no lag through the pass through. It's very clean. It's awesome. I actually record with the HDMI input from my PS3 with that little device right there, which is a HDMI converter box for DVI to HDMI. So what I do is I stick a DVI to HDMI cable in there, and it goes in a DVI here. This converts it to HDMI, Then I hook that up to this, and I'm set. I can do up to 1080p, HDMI signal, a lot cleaner. It also takes the audio from there too, if you want to do the audio through an optical cable. And works great. I got a video up on it. I'll leave that video. Link will be in the description showing how to do it and where to buy the equipment that I actually have, that I use. There's many videos on YouTube to find out, you know what I'm saying, so you can get past bypassing the HDCP, which is the encryption that's on all Blu-ray players because of the fact that they don't want you stealing, you know, ripping Blu-ray, you know, movies and shit like that. But in the software, it gives you Xbox 360, PS3, and other. So I just put it, when I'm hooking it up to the PS3 through the HDMI cable, I put it on other because on the PS3 it doesn't let you select, you know, HDMI. It only keeps it at component. So if you don't have one of those converters and you don't have that type of setup, you're gonna have to use the component cables. But being that the bitrate is so high and that the hub hogs, this one on my app went up to 12.5 megabytes per second. And this just being that the bitrate is so high, it's automatically you're gonna get better. You're gonna get better quality. The higher the bitrate, the better the quality. So would I suggest this? It's a little bit more expensive than the HD PVR2. I'll give you examples of how easy this was compared to the HD PVR2, even with people that I know that had it working right. The HD PVR2 has an actual physical button to hit the record, and it's only about more than half the size of this. You know, it's small. It's real small compared to this, but it's, you could three of these to the side and two up, and it still would be bigger than, you know what I'm saying, this. It's probably, you know, a good eighth of the size of times bigger than that. But the software on this is great. It has a thing called the flashback, and what it does is it caches the last 30 minutes that you've been playing. And you can, if you didn't hit the record button, you can go back, pick a spot to record at, hit record, then drag the marker back over to the live commentary if you're visually watching cues, you know what I'm saying? If not, you know, it'll just keep on recording. But that right there, in general, saves you a lot because sometimes you forget to hit the record button and you're just more focused on your gameplay and stuff like that. So it takes a lot of anxiety and tension off of your hands when it comes to doing multitasking so much. You know, you have your head in so many places that you sometimes you just do forget you're human. So they did great with that. No other device I've seen offers that. A lot of people were telling me about this device, and I was just like, nah, I got the HD PVR2. Gaming edition, I want to check this out, blah, blah, blah. Well, I don't have a PC, as you see, I have a Mac behind me, and it didn't support it. And I tried running through the software through Parallels, and it just didn't emulate it. It wasn't doing it, unless I put, you know, Windows on Boot Camp and stuff like that and do it the right way. And even then, people like Broken Games HD couldn't get the recording button to work and would just didn't see the value in it. And I don't see the value in it. Like I said, to me, this is the new industry standard when it comes to it. Roxio has a new Game Capture HD, which is a HDMI. It's a little bit bigger than this. And that is more for people that have like Twitch accounts and they have software that helps you, you know, live stream and stuff like that. And that right there doesn't, it's only geared towards PC. You can't be a Mac user neither. And I think companies, just in that aspect alone, are very much overlooking a big, broad market base because there's plenty of people that have Macs to do this type of stuff or want to get into this type of stuff. And this had the old software. You could use the iTV or the Game Capture HD, you know what I'm saying, HD PVR capture software that you had to buy. On top of buying this, you had to buy it. It was $30. So I got all the software for it, and I tried hooking it up to the newer version of it, and it didn't support any of it. And I don't think that they're going to be... Elgato makes the, you know, ITV and the new software for this one, and I don't think they're going to be supporting the Hub Hog anymore because they're direct competitors now. They're not... I wouldn't support another, you know what I'm saying, another company's product. It would just kill, you know, it might kill their bottom line. Anyways, it's a great product. It did, when you see it, it doesn't say that it actually comes with this. And I actually had to call the company and they said, yeah, it comes with this. It doesn't say on the box it comes with this. It doesn't say anywhere on any of the websites that it comes with this part. And this would have been a big deal breaker for me because, like I said, I do my live commentary using my mixer. And this is a big part of it, using the analog, you know, left and right audio analog signal. So I give this device a 9.5 out of 10. The only reason why I don't give it a perfect 10 is because I haven't gotten to use it. I only been able to use it on my MacBook Pro, and I'm waiting to get the new operating system Lion to put on my Mac Pro so I can record like gameplay from my computer and stuff like that, like from Steam and all that stuff. So as soon as I get that, I'll update the score, see if it actually lets me play gameplay and doesn't tax my system enough to make me the gameplay, you know, I can put everything on ultra settings and play like Counter-Strike Global Offensive on the highest settings and it not tax my computer, you know what I'm saying? Now, another thing with the software actually has all types of settings. You can go in there, edit your video, and then select what type of file it's going to be, you know, shipping. It'll do MP4, it'll do ProRes, it'll do files for your iPod, your iPad, for YouTube, for Facebook, for you know what I'm saying, all that stuff, for email. Wonderful software. It just so much complements the hardware that they have. It's free. I mean, basically it's a match made in heaven. I mean, a little bit more than its competitors, but definitely worth the price. I think it's like $168.97 on Amazon.com right now, and I actually got an Amazon Prime thing, and I got it once. It was like $178 with free 2-day shipping. And wonderful device. Like I said, 9.5 out of 10. It is awesome. It is very discreet and very portable, and just, you know, it's beast. It sets the new industry standard. Has all types of file formats that it goes to. Very powerful software. Very light. Very even nice looking. You know what I'm saying? It's a fingerprint magnet, of course, because it's piano black. But doesn't really get hot. I mean, I've had it on for a long time, and it got a little warm. Other than that, nice and cool. Doesn't make no noise. All that good stuff. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos like that, like this, you can subscribe to catch all my videos in your inbox. If you want, you could also hit that little button that says, you know, email me every time I upload a video. I usually upload a video anywhere from 1 or 2 times a day. You can follow me on Twitter. You can like me on Facebook. You can, you know what I'm saying, follow me on Google+. You could go to my website, multiplayergametrap.com. You know, got blogs, vlog forums, chat box. You know, you might see me in there once a day for an hour or two, you know, making sure everything's going good. You got other my content partners, they embed their videos on there on the front page. I have a section where my videos are at, all my latest videos, like at the bottom of the main page. So if you don't you don't want to go on it, YouTube or anything, you can always go to the website and just check it out. I write articles, put them on there, gives me a better, it's a better place to have written stuff, stuff that you can't do on YouTube. So check that out. If you want to help my channel grow, takes 1 second of your time, hit that thumbs up button. It does help my channel grow. Shout outs to all the people that came and watched my live stream last Monday. It was for 2 hours. It was like an hour and 59 minutes and 27 seconds. Yes, I memorized all this type of stuff. And it was awesome answering all your questions. If you haven't checked out that video, links will be in the description. My last two video links will be in the description. Links to the unboxing, to all the test, quality tests of this. Everything. I even have quality tests of the component cables, the HD, how I got it on the HDMI, all that good stuff. Kudos to Elgato for making such a great product. And I had to actually see it to believe it, you know what I'm saying, how good it was, or why people were just like saying, hey, you got to get this, you got to get this. And I actually was just like, you know, I just wanted to get my hands on the other product, and it was brand new, it just came out and stuff like that. I did an unboxing, and let me tell you something, I just sent it back, you know, got my money back, and got this product, and am loving it. So versatile, so great. Before I go, these are the games I've been playing lately. I've been playing Dead Space 2, Dead Space 1, Killzone 3, Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm Generations, and Starhawk. And I actually was playing this and was mad because the game's been out for quite a while and the mics are still broken on it. I was trying to play with a friend and couldn't hear him. He couldn't hear me. And I waited for another game. So I uninstalled it, and, you know, for the people that made this, shame on y'all. Game's been out forever, and it's like, you know what I'm saying, still got issues. Anyways, I've been your host, your commentator, Freddy Fuego, Flame of Hot Entertainment. Sorry to take up so much of your time, but this is my review for the Elgato Game Capture HD. Go check it out. All the links will be in the description. It is PC and Mac compatible, unlike its competitors. In this day and age, I believe that's where they slip and the Elgato has gripped. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.